Friends, merfolk, countrymen, it's time once again for Shabby MTG. Welcome in, merfolks. Anybody on YouTube, anybody watching on Twitch, we are getting down with some merfolk again in modern today. I don't really have that much time, so we are just going to dive right into it. I think this looks reasonable. A 1 into a 2, into a flash 2. We've got our green, 2 sources of green. We can hit. Okay, so I'm not really going to go over current deck lists and all this sort of thing today, unfortunately, but tomorrow is a new month and we're going to wipe the slate clean on our little merfolk tracker, and I'm going to update my spreadsheet and we're going to see how we did in the month of October. ArborElf. They just have to do this to me, don't they? They just have to do this to me early in the morning. Forest ArborElf, they just have to. I guess we just go for maximum aggression here, which would be like this. Because we might get who knows what. Get some of our lands killed. Let's see. Yeah, we do have this updated for the most part. We did go 4-1 on Monday. So, alright, I guess this is going to be Ponza or some such nonsense. Which I guess we just have to rush. And they had Utopia Sprawl the whole time. So then they can do something. This might be the... We played, I think, Monday. We played like a Karn version. Which, you know, we'll see. Could be Chandra, could be Garrick. I've seen everything for 4. Domery, Anarch of Bolas, eh? What does that do? Just straight up gives his creatures +1/+0. And he wants to fight me. Okay. Interesting. And then he has another ArborElf. Off of what? Oh, I see. I see what happened. Well, I guess this is going to initiate the death of this Domery. Or do I just see if he'll trade again? That I'm not really sure if... Is it better to just tap it down right now or go in, try to get him to trade? 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess we'll see if he wants to trade first. Because then we can do something like Trickster the ArborElf in the upkeep, if, you know, depending on what kind of mana situation he thinks he has. So we're going to attack Domery in this case. I think it's right to just offer the trade here. See what else he might have up his sleeve. He has 3 cards left. But, you know, this puts him to the test depending on how expensive some of the other stuff in his hand is. So he does not want to block. So we're going to play our second Kamena Speaker. We're going to play our Botanical Sanctum. We're going to say go to his upkeep. And in his upkeep, we're going to rock out with Trickster. So he, you know, I was just hoping that he's calculating, all right, he, you know, maybe has something that costs four or five. And I can cast a four at least. What is this gonna be? Bloodbraid Elf, eh? Bone Crusher Giant, okay. So he has a 4-3 and a 3-2 now. Interesting. And if I target that, right. These freaking pawns decks. Or whatever the hell this is. I guess it's not really. They do have some land destruction. Okay, what's happening, opponent? Are you going to play your Bone Crusher Giant? Are you going to sit here and allow me to sip on my coffee? Well, we will be right back. All right, we're back. So he finally figured out how to cast. Oh, he's allowed to stomp with that? That's interesting. I did not know that it worked that way. So no. I guess we just have to bash in here. We're kind of behind now that he has a 3-2 on deck. So I think we're pretty behind, and what gets us back is something like maybe spreading seeds on this Utopia Sprawl Forest into a Lord would be ideal. Now what's happening? Two red and one. Maybe he has another Domery. Gruul Spellbreaker, a 3-3 hexproof. Interesting. Okay, so this is a very aggressive. This isn't true Ponza or that. Let's see. Yeah. Don't think we're gonna make it again with the pony decks on the first freaking round. We never seem to like get scrubby decks except for the first round. Probably all those like Grixis Death Shadow players were beating in the fifth round are thinking the same thing. Three, four, five. Glory Bringer? Are you fucking kidding me? This is just... Alright. This is just freaking ridiculous. Glory Bringer, Bone Crusher, Gruul Spellbreaker. Alright. Really, none of this shit helps us out. Deprive actually does help us out. Other than that... What else do we trim on? I guess maybe we trim on forces. I guess Damping Sphere stops the Utopia Sprawl. I don't really know how good it is, though. Actually, you know, it does also stop... It does also slow down the cascade. Who knows? I don't know why this is in there, by the way. I was playing with this on Monday, and I meant to go back to, I believe it was 3 relics, 2 cages, or maybe it was 3 cages, 2 relics. And I think I just left one of these in there. We're on 2 cages, 2 relics, so that's okay. Stuff like this happens, though. Stuff like that, exactly like that, will happen. You're going to, like, have situations where you don't register your deck properly. All sorts of different things where you might be playing, you know, you might be playing with a substandard deck. Or just a deck that, you know, has a one-off. Even within the realm of Merfolk, there's Simic Merfolk, Mono Blue Merfolk, which play differently. And then you got, you know, Hayashi Merfolk, which plays pretty, I wouldn't say radically different, but fairly differently from the other two versions of Merfolk. I guess we're going to have to try to try out some red Merfolk, if red is going to get some Merfolks in the next set. Though sometimes they like to just put random creature types on some of these different legends. If you haven't seen it, it's like there's like a blue red Merfolk legend that I think it taps for artifact mana. Like, you get 2 colorless that you can only spend on artifact mana and activations of artifacts. Now, if they gave us a way to search that out, okay, we sat here and we've waited the whole, whatever it is, 2 minutes and 30 seconds for the sideboarding. This is very aggressive. But it could be a mulligan, actually, given... I guess we'll keep it. He went to 6. Alright. Now, they may be a Bloodmoon deck, or be siding into Bloodmoon, so that's going to be something to be... weary about here. It might make me just do this Flooded Strand off the get-go and get an island with it. All right. Another Lord already. Do we think they have Renin 6 or something like that? I don't think so. Alright, another Lord. Jeez. The context of our lands, we may have wanted to lead out on a Lord right there. If we get locked into a situation where on turn 4... So maybe he's gone into Sweepers? I don't know why he's chilling out here. Deprive seems okay. I guess we'll just drop a lure and see what happens. I'm assuming he has one of those stomps or some sort of something. But I want to get myself into a position here where I can cast my lords and then also hold up deprive. But I'm also hedging with this vault out that I want to just attack with. Okay, I'm guessing he's going to just... Oh, he did have Magus of the Moon. Okay. So now we need an island. Oh, now we're just straight up flunked. Wow. Yeah. Maybe this should have been a lord. Then we would have been able to Bloodbraid Elf cascading into Sprawl. Okay. I think we may be boned again here. These moon effects are so good versus us. Alright, we need one of our few islands here. Damping Sphere. Well, that would have been nice last time. I'm just gonna hold up so he can't attack with the Magus. Or if he wants to trade it out or whatever. It still works. I guess it's triggered. Alright, we're just going to go on to game or match two here. See if we can find a reasonable tier deck to practice against. Every time it's a fucking pony deck. Every time it's one of those kind of decks, too. It's always a fucking Utopia Sprawl deck. Sure. We don't play this deck. You don't play a 20 land, 4 Aether Vial deck to not keep hands like this. So we just see mountain. What is this gonna be? Is this burn or is this something else? They have 8 cards in hand and they're just pausing in their main. Castle Embreth. Creatures you control. Okay, maybe this is like a token deck or something, or goblins. What's happening? Eidolon. Okay, so this is like pseudo burn. Seems a little loose. We're going to take 3 here. Sure. Well, we're not 100% sure if this is just burn or what. But I think we'll just go for a lord here. Because after this, we're going to just have a pile of creatures, and this is going to get traded off pretty quick, I'm assuming. Ramenap runes. Desperate ritual, huh? Okay. Eidolon and desperate ritual. Chandra torture defiance. Okay. Is it going to be a -3? Exile. Legion War Boss. Oh, okay. This is not the deck I thought it was. So now we want a Trickster here so we can kill the Chandra. Okay, Merfolk Trick. Okay, we're going to tap down the Eidolon. Yeah, this is the, I don't know, Dragon Stompy is what they call it in all creatures attack Chandra for 5. Now, I don't know if I want to mess around with this Spreading Seas or not. Don't think I. No, actually, I think I do. Okay. Because, let's see. 3 lords make everything 5s. Gonna have to do a little math here. Well, actually, putting that Spreading Seas on there also has made him possibly in for some life if he needs more than 1 red mana. Alright, what's this? Goblin Rabble Master. Yes, indeed. You are rabbling. We're going to say yes, we're going to, well, all right, let's do the math now. The math works out that those are going to be 4, 4, so 4, 8, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17. All right, so we can put the Lord in here. Go to box. Forget to put this other lord in. And this should be it. Another lord. All merfolk, great and small, charge. No blockies. Alright, what do we do against these kind of decks? Force of Negation seems very strong. Okay. Deprive, right? I guess we maybe trim on some lords. There's not really much else we want to trim on. They do have they do have Stamping Sphere help us? Land is tapped. No, it doesn't really help us that much. Might consider it on the play. But they have Blood Moon effects in this deck, which is, again, really bad for us. I don't think this is the kind of hand we can keep versus a deck that can produce a turn one Blood Moon. This is better. I think it's one of the forces. Ooh. Heloco. Heloco. I did take the cards I shaved on were the Multicolored Lords and the Simian Spirit Guide. What? He's just stomping it, huh? Bonecrusher Giant is a pretty cool card. It's kind of like the opposite, the counter. The Brazen Borrower. Castle Embreath. Okay. He kept the Eidolons in. So bizarre. Alright, well, we're not afraid of Eidolon. Oko's ultimate work has to be power, 3 or less. And then we're gonna upbraid. I think we gotta stop that and then rely on Oko. We definitely want to get this out before and I think we're just gonna make a bunch of dudes. Hang back, make a bunch of dudes. They have 3 cards in hand, they have this Bonecrusher Giant they can play. Okay, they're playing it. Mm-hmm. Where does that get him? Windy. What are we trying to accomplish here? I guess he's deciding if he wants to trade this Eidolon off. We do want to trade it off. Ugh. Botanical Sanctum has to be tapped. Get this in before any Blood Moon effects come out. And turn our food into dude. Food into dude. Like, he's the Thief of Crowns, but, like, what is he doing? He's stealing the food? Uh-oh, here comes their... They're 4 drop. This is like... He's casting a Simian Spirit Guide. Interesting. That doesn't do much. I'll I guess we just go with more of the same. Make Oko huge. Gemstone Caverns, that's right. I do remember playing this deck. And we just start gone, okay. Let's update our spreadsheet here. My grill deck, we lost. And we lost. And this next one over here was a red prison, which we won 1-2-0'd. Alright, we are on the draw. Well, this seems reasonable, unless there's Blood Moon effects. They mulligan to 6. Bloodstainmire. Watery Grave Shock. Stitcher Supplier. Okay. Merfolk Secret Keeper Narcomoeba. Overgrown Tomb. I just don't know what this is, so we're just gonna go Aether Vial Go. Merfolk Secret Keeper Stitcher Supplier Narcomoeba. Is this Pony Day? I think we've actually played against this a similar deck to this, like. Glimpse the unthinkable on their self. Right. The Carrion Feeder deck. Okay, so they get another Narcomoeba. What is their deck looking like? Hadron Crab. Oh, Vengevine. That's what it is. Vengevine deck. We've had this deck as like our first deck of the. We could cut them off green, or we could just develop our board. Which I think we're just going to develop our board. We should do Silver Gill Adept. And then show them the one we're going to vial in. Okay. Brazen Borrower can like bounce a Carrion Feeder. Haunted Dead, that just comes back for. They discard 2, return it to the battlefield tapped. More Shocky Shocky. Yeah. Another Creeping Chill. Now we're about to get double Vengevine. Did we just get rid of this Stitcher Supplier? 10? I'm gonna do it. Did it. Let's see what he's gonna get. Hopefully we don't get 3'd. Okay. Another Hadron Crab goes down. I guess if he kills this, he can kill that because we have no island. And we can block one of these Narcomoebas if we really want to. I don't think we really want to. I think what we really want to do is just green, blue, cast this right here, and swing on in. What is he pausing for here? What kind of removal does this run? Carrion feeder, stitcher supplier, hedron crab, a lot of ones. You know what's coming. Big eight. And then next turn it's 4, 8, 9, 10, 11 unblockable. So something huge and enormous and crazy has to happen here. Or actually, I guess you just need to remove on the Lord. Yeah. Ooh, you got a 1-5 island walker. Now what? Right. He's about to vengevine me. Okay. All right, so we have to block one of these here. Now, how is this gonna work? Gonna work like this. We can. No, I think we have to leave the Lord up and hope for another Lord. 4, 5, 6. Yeah. Has to be like this. 4, 5, 6. Then we go to 4. And then, what's he got? 2? These island walkers could actually be big too if we were to play an island. Beautiful, huh? Ay, ay, ay. Well. If we're gonna go all in here, it seems to me that the best way to do that is to tap a colorless and a blue, and spreading sees the overgrown tomb. Mm-hmm. Let's see maybe if we can find a lure. All right, so we cannot find the Lord. So what does that mean? We're forced into bouncing the Vengevine and then taking 1, 2, 3, and we would be at 1. We played a land. This is going to put him to 7. We do not have an island. Now, any kind of shenanigans like whatever these things are called, creeping chills, are just gonna kill us. Mm-hmm. cannot live if he has anything. So we just block like this. And we'll petty theft over here. Maybe they play Stubborn Denial or something? Because, no. Okay, we go to one. And if he has a way to mill, he might be able to kill us. Up. I'll just go like this. I guess whatever. We attack with everything. Phew. Okay, that was a crazy one. What do we want to take out? Spreading Seas, right? Bring in the chalices, bring in the relics, bring in the graft digger's cage. How does Vengevine actually read? Vengevine says whenever you may return it from a graveyard. Okay. So it's just returning. Alright. Is it force and negation? Probably. Brazen Borrower was okay. Oko might be a little lackluster. You know, Oko could be more like a deprive or something, or force and negation. Yeah, shoot. What else are they gonna have? To check out this is another important thing to do, is if you have a few minutes, go and look at a Vengevine deck. Yeah, here it is. Okay, they have Gravecrawler, Hedron Crab, Secret Keeper. Alright, it's going to be Collective Brutality, Fatal Push, Nature's Claim, Thought Seize, just a bunch of ones. Assassin's Trophy is a way to kill off one of our things, though. I guess Damping Sphere does make it a little harder to do some things. I don't know. I'm really just bringing it in because it should be our fifth whatever, right? That should just be, that probably would be our sideboard plan, right? Take out the Spreading Seas, take out the Force of Negation. I'm gonna mulligan. I want to get a turn one graveyard interaction when I'm on the draw. By the time I get to my second turn, there, you know, we could already be getting Vengevined. All right, there we go. We're going to keep that, and we're going to put a Damping Sphere, and maybe we put the Lord, and we just pray that we draw one of our many merfolk. Venturing deeper. Okay, Gravecrawler. Alrighty. Oh, and they wanna tempt me with the Aether Vial. We're just gonna straight up cage so there's no Gravecrawler shenanigans. I think if I draw a Merfolk next turn, I'll play the Chalice, and if not, then I'll. Why don't you go ahead and play that? We did draw Merfolk, so I think I'll just go ahead and play this Chalice on one, since it shuts off like his whole deck. And let's see. Carrion Feeder, Grave Crawler, Hedron Crab, Merfolk Secret Keeper, plus Venture Deeper. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. Can we always use it? Does he have a Vengevine in there? Alright, and we just took that one down. Real quick and proper. This is Vengevine. That was a 1/1/2/0. Maul to hate. Maul to cage into chalice. Game two. Game two. Okay. Those damn Groll decks. Would like to play first. Three lords seems reasonable versus an unknown opponent, right? Plus we have a vault. As long as we don't run into some sort of like turn one blood moon. Or is it gonna be a this deck, eh? We've been wanting to run into this deck. I think we really hope to draw an untapped blue source, because we can Ancient Stirrings. What are we looking at now? Cavern of Souls. And a stronghold and an amulet. We could be dead next turn. Alright, this is what we wanted. Green, blue, Mistbinder. Okay. So the next turn we're going to be attacking with 5/5s. Field of the Dead, alright. This is just such a rough matchup for us. This is one of the tier decks that is a rough one for us. If we Boros Garrison, okay. They have not played a land, so they can generate like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but not double green. Human. Oh, is this Azusa? Is Azusa a human? They put this on. Let's always yield to that. I don't think this always yield really works, because it was is you said lost but seeking. Oh no, I did remember that we could do that. Okay, now they're on giant. Spreading seas. Interesting. I guess we could put a spreading seas on a Slayer stronghold. No, I think the spreading seas just needs to be our lethal. I think it'll be way more helpful to have 2 5-5s. To deal with a big giant. Ooh. Well, that I like. That tells me that he doesn't necessarily have the ability to go off here. Now, of course, what they can do is they can hold up the scout with a garrison or, you know, a bounce lane in their hand. And on our turn, when we go to Spreading Seas, they can tap the scout. Summoner's Pact, okay. Does this get it done? That's the question. 1, 2. Just to tap everything. Yeah. You got it, dude. Now let's think about the combo for a second. They have to have a Slayer Stronghold and a red and a white. And then it'll become an 8-8. Right? Yeah, an 8-8. They attack again. Aha, okay, Vesuva. Now what's happening? He's untapping. He copied the garrison. Alright, right. So that's going to... Oh, I see what he's going to do. Alright, that bounces the garrison. Now he has to bounce something else. I think he bounced the Vesuva. Because then it can come in as a copy of something else later. But that could be wrong. He returns the other Boros garrison. Okay. So now we have Haste Vigilance. And then he can do us for some double strike damage, right? Do we have it or do we not have it? That's the question. I believe that it costs 4 to do that double strike thing, right? The land. Let's look this up while we watch our opponent stumble through this a little bit. This is Amulet Titan. Amulet combo? Okay. Alright, let's see. What is the name of that land? Sunhome, the Fortress of the Legion. 1 red, one white, two colorless, target creature gains double strike. What is this castle garbage? Okay, that's six. Choose a card from your library. He's still sitting here trying to choose. I think this is how we have to beat this. Like the, I think that's one thing is I. Oh yeah, okay. He's going for Field of the Dead win or something. What is he doing here? Okay, Field of the Dead. Field of the Dead. Untap. Untap. Now what does he have to do? He has to bounce something. Do we... Why didn't you return? He returns forest. Do we kill this thing right here? He is going to have the ability to bounce and get another prime time. We'll just take it. It's not double strike. Ooh. Now he's taking down his defense here. Oh, does he have, shit, he has engineered explosives for two. Now we're boned. Okay, game two. God, they need to ban this fucking deck. They need to just ban Amulet. It's just so ridiculous. I guess Damping Sphere does something. Deprives definitely do something. Let's look at their freaking... sideboard. They got a bunch of creatures and stuff. What would be bad versus us? Their own Okos, Reclamation Sage, Anglehorn. Spreading Seas. Well, actually, Spreading Seas you do need to get by the zombies. So what's another reasonable cut? A Kumana Speaker? Merfolk Trickster, maybe? No. God, this is just such a rough matchup for us. Actually, maybe Oko is the cut. That's okay, I guess. We can't cast this Deprive. But it is aggressive. Double Lord, Kumana Speaker. If we draw any regular blue source. Okay, he's on six. Looking for a turn one Amulet, maybe? Let's put this on our spreadsheet here. Amulet. Oh, actually, this was a total mistake to do that, right? Nah, we would probably not need Deprive by turn two, but I could be wrong. You know, if he has an amulet right here. He does have an amulet right here. Force of Negation. Let's just do a blue and a blue for this dude. Yeah, it would have been nice to force that amulet. But maybe we could force like a Once Upon a Time or like a Engineered Explosives. second amulet. Oof, out of coffee. That's why we're failing. Bounce. There's the Azusa Lost Basiki. Okay. Another Amulet of Vigor, huh? Okay. I guess we just have to counter the, like, let him generate all the mana and counter the big thing. If there is a big thing. And then you let it resolve. And then you tap it again. I guess he doesn't want to tap it again. He wants to EE on 2. Alright, we'll deprive that. Dismember. Weird. Very weird. Okay. We need to just run. Spreading Seas. Should we Spreading Seas his Boros garrison? It doesn't really make much sense, but we're going to do it. Flooded Strand. Now we just cross our fingers and hope that he doesn't draw anything. Oh, he didn't draw anything. Now we have one more deprive and two more force of negations. So we are gonna. So having double blue up for those. I'm gonna do breeding pool now. Okay, we're gonna say nope. Botanical Sanctum. So in that case, we'll just draw a force. And we're gonna hope he doesn't draw anything. Actually, we're gonna hope he draws, like, you know, not a bounce land. Or another amulet would be cool. Or actually even a prime time, because he couldn't really do anything with it. Who knows what he drew? Artifact removal or something. He's waiting in my upkeep. Maybe he did. What kind of artifact removal do they play? Engineer explosive, disdainful stroke, dismember, wreck sage. No, there's not. Not really all that much. I wonder if Collector Oaf is worth bringing in for, so they can't use the so they can't use the engineered explosives. Well, ooh, we can counter that. He's going to be able to get us again. Yay, yay. Yeah, you have it, dude. It's so... Yeah, now there you go. Untap and tap it. Come on, opponent. Mm-hmm. Then he's going to transmute. For a summoner's pack, cast the summoner's pack. Yep. I don't know why they just didn't ban Amulet of Vigor back when they banned Summer Bloom. It would have been so much easier. And now, what does he get? Another Teleria West, and then he's gonna get us with a get us with an engineered explosives again. Does another summoner's pact. Okay. Does that give us an out? I'm not sure. What depends on what he does here. Looks like Vesuvius Slayer Stronghold, Boros Garrison copy. And then he'll give one vigilance. F6, man. We still have one Spreading Seas left. If that, if we can draw our last Spreading Seas in the deck, we can still win. So I'm not going to concede here. But as you can see, this, I mean, Amulet's just freaking ridiculous. Oh, he gave them both haste and vigilance. Okay, well now we can just concede. Amulet. What was that? Let's just type broken deck is broken. think if I had my way, I'd like to see Urza and Amulet and maybe Mox Opal banned. That probably would be my top three. Let's see, we're in 02202002. So we're just looking to get our money back here. Maybe I should have gone back to actually using the 2-0. What do you call it? Damping spheres. Sure. TNT on fire. Oh, our favorite deck. Maybe. Is it Grixis Death Shadow? Looks like it. Do you know which one to take? Guessing no. Takes the Lord. Well, that would be the last choice I would make, but another vault, okay. I wonder if we try to start getting in with the taking a look again. Maybe he has. Yeah, he's gonna Thought Scour me. No, he Thought Scours himself. Do we have an Angler? Death Shadow. 1-1 Death Shadow. Jeez. Sees, okay. He is going to have a big boy. Is this the Gurmag Angler? What is it? It's nothing. It's Fatal Push. Okay, we're just gonna block with our vault. Spreading sea is interesting. Maybe as a bolt, this can induce it. Snapcaster, okay. Blocks, he fatal pushes. So play me to vault, say go. I wonder if we should try to. No, I think I'm gonna take it. Nope, no, I might not want to take it. I will take it. That's not bad. How's this gonna work out, though? We can take him to one. And then the Death Shadow's lethal. So I don't think I want to do that. I'm not gonna let the Death Shadow lethal us. So in that case, it'll just be like this. So dangerous. I guess if he has like a bolt, snap bolt, something like that. The Royal Scions, okay. Another Death Shadow. We'll block in case he has a way to cycle the, what do you call it? Da, da, da. Just like we drew it up. Okay, so we want to sideboard out our Spreading Seas, sideboard in our Chalice of the Voids. Relic of Progenesis is also reasonable. I think Force of Negation is a good, an easy cut. We could consider Deprive. We could consider, I'm not going to consider Damping Sphere. Too cute. Damping Sphere, I think, really needs to be limited to like the amulet deck, Tron. Maybe we could trim an oaf and go up to two and then keep our. I guess I'll keep it. We could also consider trimming on some Aether Vials. But I think the tempo they bring is still pretty important. I think. Now we just have a bunch of creatures. And I'm guessing he has a bunch of removal. Here is our lowest rank creature in our hand, I would say. Well, I mean, I guess Kumana Speaker is... What does he have? Oh, he just did it for... I think I'm just going to play one of these, and then, actually I'll play both. Too strong not to have, not to play, be able to hit for six island walk on a whim. Snapcaster Fatal Push, yeah. Okay. That might be a little aggressive. Sure. That might be a little aggressive too. He might have a Death Shadow here. Snapcaster Mage Thoughtseize, okay. Interesting. Yeah. I guess we can at least Trickster Snapcaster. Ooh. Me likey. Tap that down. Alright, so now we have Lethal on the board. He's got to be blocking. What does he have here? Dreadbore. Interesting. I guess that's good versus Oko. Lord. It's a Lord, I guess. Does help versus this. Turns this into lethal. Now we'll see if he has some. Okay. Maybe has a sweeper. What? What's happening here? Thought scours a dismember and Amishra's bauble. Yes! Yes! Alright, well, we got our money back. And we got a. I guess we got a treasure chest. Maybe we'll have to sell our treasure chest and see if we can buy something. So, anyway, let's. Let's take a look at this. This is what we were playing. I think if we want another Damping Sphere, it might look like this. That way we would have four graveyard interactions plus three additional counter spells to go up to a total of six plus, you know, Chalice. So, anyway, if you're watching on Twitch, thank you. If you're watching the replay on Twitch, thanks again. If you're watching on YouTube, throw me a thumbs up, a subscribe. It really helps. If you're looking for some real honest and goodness Merfolk content, check out Nikachu on YouTube. hit up the Fish MTG subreddit on Reddit. Join us in the Discord. There's also there's a few people that actually do Twitch streams somewhat reasonably on a reasonable schedule. There's also, let's see, Tux does legacy streams of Merfolk sometimes, and Lord Magicus has a YouTube channel. Check that out. There's lots of Merfolk content out there for y'all. But of course, here at Shabby MTG, we're just about the common man picking up a, you know, average deck and seeing how competitive we can get with it. So until tomorrow, goodbye and good luck.